Thank you for watching videos by Jeff Sibelius and landandairphotos.com. Today I'll take you on part two of my comprehensive walkthrough of the DJI Fly app, including an explanation of some new features recently added with version 1.1.0. In this episode, I'll cover the overflow menu, also called the settings menu. This episode is part of a series of tutorials I'm doing on the DJI Mavic Mini. A link to the playlist is in the upper right corner of the screen. If you plan to buy a Mavic Mini, follow the link in the description below and order direct from DJI. Now, on to this tutorial. I'm going into great detail on the app, so I've broken this walkthrough into two parts. This is part two, the overflow menu, also called the settings menu. If you haven't watched part one yet, I encourage you to follow the link in the upper right corner now to watch that episode before this one. You can see the entire script of this video with some additional information in my show notes at landandairphotos.com. Follow the link in the description below. That's it for the camera view. Now let's tap the three-dot icon in the upper right corner to open the settings. This is the settings screen, or overflow screen. You see that you have five tabs of settings for the Mavic Mini: safety, control, camera, transmission, and about. I'll walk you through each screen. The safety tab provides a lot of the options you had when you tapped the aircraft status indicator from the camera view. It has the maximum altitude and distance, auto return to home altitude settings, things like that. But you can also do other things here. You can change your home point from this screen. By default, your home point is where you launch, but you can actually reset that here. You can calibrate your compass or IMU here. You can unlock a geo zone if you get permission from DJI to fly in a no-fly zone area. Remote identification is coming, but it's not here yet, so I'll pass on that one for now. Find My Drone helps you to do exactly that. If your drone comes down and you can't find it, Find My Drone helps you locate it. You can tell the drone to start flashing and beeping to make it easier to find from this screen. I've done a whole tutorial on Find My Drone. A link to that is in the upper right corner now. Back to the menu. Advanced Safety Features opens a subscreen. You can set what the drone does if the signal is lost: return to home, descend, or hover. Return to home is probably the one you want, but you can see why you might want to update your home point if you move during the flight. If the drone disconnects, it's programmed by default to return to that home position. You can adjust your emergency stop settings. I suggest you leave those alone. Finally, you have payload mode. If you get the Fly More combo and want to fly with the propeller guards, turn on this switch and the Mini will compensate for the additional weight of the guards. Otherwise, leave it turned off. That's the safety tab. Moving on to the control tab. You see the flight modes: cinesmooth, position, and sport. You can change them here as well. Units allows you to choose metric or imperial settings for your telemetry display. Gimbal mode changes how your gimbal behaves. Follow mode sets the gimbal to stay level as you bank the drone, pretty much what you normally expect. FPV mode allows the gimbal to bank as you bank the drone, like you see from one of those racing drones, like you're sitting in the cockpit. Normally, you want follow mode for the best effect when shooting video. Advanced Gimbal Settings opens a submenu. You can adjust how slowly and smoothly the gimbal tilts up and down. Allow Upward Gimbal Rotation allows the gimbal to pan higher than straight forward. By default, the camera will point straight forward and down. Let me activate this and show you what it does. Now you can see the camera will actually point higher than straight forward. I personally don't like this setting, but it does allow you to point your camera upwards in the situation that you're flying beneath something, like a bridge, for example. I'll deactivate it for now. That's it for advanced gimbal settings. Gimbal calibration is used if your camera is tilted to one side when it should be level. Recenter gimbal does just that. Remote controller settings you'll typically leave alone. Stick mode lets you swap your stick functions. The normal setting is mode 2, where the left stick moves the drone up and down and spins it, and the right stick moves the drone horizontally. You can choose mode 1 to swap these stick functions if you want. If you do, 99% of all instruction manuals, videos, and everything else will not apply to you because almost everyone flies in mode 2. I suggest you leave this one alone. RC calibration allows you to calibrate the RC if that's needed. I've never had to do that with the DJI drone. Flight tutorials are buried here for some reason. And at the bottom, you can repair the link from the controller to the drone if that's ever needed. That's the control tab. Moving on to camera tab. You can choose your still image aspect ratio, 4:3, which is closer to a square, or 16:9, which is the standard YouTube orientation. That's what you'll get when you shoot video with the Mini. Format allows you to format your media card. Beneath that, you see a display of your card's current usage. Beneath that is advanced shooting settings. This opens a submenu. This is a good submenu to discuss because they've added a valuable tool here with the latest version of the Fly app, and I want to point it out. Anyway, your first choice on advanced shooting settings is the histogram. I had this on before and turned it off. If I turn it on, you'll see it along the left edge now. This is a graphical representation of your exposure. If the graph is balanced more to the left, your image is darker. If it's balanced to the right, your image is brighter. In general, a graph that is weighted to the middle indicates a good average exposure. That is obviously affected by subject matter and lighting, but it's a good rule of thumb. I like leaving my histogram on, so I'll activate that. Overexposure warning is the zebra pattern you saw on screen earlier. When your exposure is set too high, this warning will display those annoying black and white bands on any area that is overexposed. This is a good tool to use all the time, but especially if you plan to use manual settings or the AE lock. It's easy to forget to reset your exposure as you move the drone around. The zebra stripes will remind you when that's needed. Grid lines are displayed on screen to help you with your composition. The cross lines put an X on your screen, which helps find the center. The checkerboard draws a grid on your screen. This helps with your rule of thirds, a universal rule of thumb for composition. So, for example, the strongest composition might put the horizon along one of the horizontal lines like this. Rather than putting the horizon right across the middle of the screen, which just splits it in half. Based on the rule of thirds, I'd tilt the camera to put the horizon right along one of the horizontal lines. The last grid line is just a small plus sign that you can put at the center of your screen. This can help you when you're aiming the drone at a certain element of your image. White balance. This is the new feature DJI has added to the Fly app. Previously, you could not lock your white balance, so the color of your light could fluctuate in the middle of a shot, as you can see here. Now you have a choice. If you click on manual, you can adjust a slider to select the correct color temperature for your situation. If you scroll down, you can see the colors get cooler. If you slide up, you can see the colors get warmer. So, you can set it to whatever you want. And the nice thing about this is that once you set it, it won't change during your shot. Moving along, we have anti-flicker. You probably won't need to mess with this unless you're shooting something like a big light source, like a scoreboard or something, which may cause flicker in the image. Video subtitles. You can add subtitles to your video. Cache when recording is a good idea. It stores a low resolution version of your camera feed locally. You can set the cache capacity to whatever space you feel comfortable with designating on your smart device. That's it for advanced settings. Finally, at the bottom of the camera tab, you have a reset option. Before I move on, are you finding this tutorial helpful? Be sure to click the little Cartoon Jeff icon in the lower right corner of the screen so you can subscribe. I have more videos in the works now, so please don't miss them. let's go to the Transmission tab. You probably won't have any use for this tab. You can choose transmission channel settings if you want to for areas of high interference. I've never touched these settings. Last is the About tab. This tab tells us what drone we're flying, our firmware version and status. This is firmware version 01.00.01.18, which is the current version of the firmware. We can update firmware from here if we need to. You also see the FlySafe database information, which is the no-fly zone data, and you can update it. And it shows the version of the Fly app you're using. This is version 1.1.0. Below that, you can see information about the battery, how many times it's been charged, and get the serial numbers for your battery, drone, controller, and camera. And that's it! That completes the walkthrough of your DJI Fly app version 1.1.0 for the Mavic Mini. Before you go out on your first flight, I encourage you to go through your app and get familiar with it, choose the settings you want to start with, and make sure all the firmware is up to date. That way, when you go out to fly, you can focus on managing the aircraft rather than figuring out what settings you want to use. I've covered a lot of information here. If you want to review the information, you can watch this episode again or read the entire script of this video along with additional helpful information in my show notes at landandairphotos.com. Follow the link in the description below. I've got more episodes on the Mavic Mini, tutorials and reviews, so check out the playlist on screen now and keep learning. I hope you found this tutorial to be helpful. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and leave a comment. You can also join my Facebook group if you want to chat. Maybe we can fly together. Thanks for watching.